Hi guys, so in this video I'll be installing Moses SMT, which uses the statistical machine translation method to translate from source language to target language. To perform that, we need a parallel corpus. You will find a small data set, English to Hindi parallel corpus, in the description. The installation process is very difficult and takes a lot of time. To save time, the language technologies unit, there is an organization in GitHub, so they made a Docker image which contains the required files and codes. So you just need to pull the image from the Docker and make it run. We will install Docker using apt. So it will take a bit time. Docker has been installed completely, so I will just directly pull the Docker image. So there is a problem, so you have to use sudo then the Docker image. It should work. If it is not working, then maybe it's the proxy, so we have to set the proxy. Let's see. To set proxy, we have to make a file inside the system folder. It is done. And now we will just add a proxy configuration file and we'll paste these three lines. Okay, it should be saved. And just I need to restart the daemon, and then I have to restart the Docker service. Now it should pull. See, it is pulling. It will take a bit time. This is the biggest file. It will take a bit time. After that, it will be unzipping and installing all those things. So now it is started extracting the file that it has downloaded. Now you can see the pulling is completed. So now what we have to do is we have to clone the Moses SMT from GitHub. It is cloning. As you can see, it has been already cloned, and here we can see the file Moses SMT. So we have to go inside Moses SMT, and you can see the Docker file and make file. First, we'll see what's inside the make. So here, it has 1, 2, 3, 4 options. Here, if we run make run, then it will take the pwd, the path of the folder right now, and inside that it will generate one Moses models, and it will take it from the Docker. It will connect it to the Docker and it will run the Docker. Now we will run make run. So it is giving errors, so we have to sudo make run. See, it came to the Moses SMT. So now we have to check that the root of the Docker and the Moses SMT file is connected or not. If not, then we have to take some steps and we have to change the file path. So we have to check that, and if it is synced, if both of the files are synced properly, then we will go to the next process. I have downloaded the dataset inside the GitHub repo and made one folder called Moses Models. I have to go back and check Moses Models is there or not. See, Moses Models already came. So I have to go inside Moses Models. And there is nothing here. So it is not connected. We have to connect it again. We have to restart the daemon and maybe it may work after that. So I'll just get out from this Docker. And I will try to stop it using sudo make stop. It is stopped. And then now again I will do sudo make run. Now it is running. So let's check it is connected or not. So there is no file, it's not connected. So what we have to do is we have to change the file path of that pwd. Maybe it is not able to detect that, and so we will stop it again. We'll stop the Docker, and now we will try to nano. There is a file called mix file. There we have to change it here. Moses SMT / Moses models. So we'll save it and I will just run it again. So as you can see, it is already running. So I will stop it once. Okay, I will remove it and I will run it again. Now it is running. So now it should work. Both of the folders should be connected. Let's see. Moses models. See, now we have pasted the dataset into the GitHub clone folder, and now it is available inside the Moses models. So you have to follow this folder structure. Inside the Moses models, we have to first make one folder ENHI. So I will make dir, I'll make a directory called ENHI, and I will make another inside that ENHI, cd ENHI, I will get into it, and inside that I have to make two folders. One is mkdirlm, language models will be saved here, another one is corpus, so it is saved. And inside this corpus folder we have to put those data sets. So we have to move this two files, ENHI.en, first ENHI, right, in corpus, it is moved, and we have to move the Hindi file also to corpus. Now let's check inside ENHI, and two four files are there. We have to check the corpus. Now inside it, two files are there. See, now we have to go back to the Moses SMT. Now we have the file moses.py. Here we have to run to train. We have to run python moses.py is the folder name. This is the source language and this is the target language. Here source language is English, target language is Hindi. So let's start training. It is already trained. Inside the Moses model folder, it should generate the language model. Let's check. Now, inside ENHI, you can see this LM is created, and we will check LM. And here you can see these language models are already generated. So we have to go back. Where are we are inside English Hindi. Here we will just create another folder called mkdir. We will create test. Then inside text folder we will be having one source.txt file. I will just paste it here, and inside that if we just check, please like and subscribe to my channel, and we'll translate it to Hindi. We'll try to. To do that, we have to paste this code. It is going to the next line, so it is giving error. Let's remove those and paste it again. So here it is already, see, just one line, so it has been tested already. So let's see the output. Here, print.txt is there. We will try to see that. Let's see, there is nothing here. So what exactly happening is in using this code, it is skipping the first line and generating the second line. So what we have to do is we have to keep the first line blank or put something which we don't need, just a header or something, and then it will give you the output. Let's do that. Now let's do that again. This one, it will give error, so you just have to copy and paste the whole thing and it is done. So let's check this time. Check it again. See, here it is giving the. It is not perfect because SMT can't be that accurate. So it is giving at least the output. That's it. Thank you, everyone.